Hi, I'm Nate Morgan with Ludlum Measurements in Sweetwater, Texas, where we've been designing, manufacturing, selling, and servicing radiation detection and measurement equipment for over 50 years now. What we're going to talk about today is handheld microR meters and their purpose in the steel industry. Many people have got gate monitors whenever they come into the mills or into the yards that will detect low-level gamma radiation, which is their purpose. But whenever you have an alarm that goes off on a truck, what do you do with the truck at that point? That's where the handheld radiation monitors come in. They're microR meters. They are better at pinpointing where in the load the radiation is. It's going to help you take a truck that's alarmed, find out what the offending source inside the truck is, and then dispose of it or deal with it properly. So we're going to go over a few of the models that we have and their importance and some of their different features. The first model we've got is the Model 19. It's kind of been the industry standard. I've heard people call it the workhorse. It's rugged, reliable, dustproof. It's got an analog meter. It's got five different ranges where you can read on. It's got annual toggle switches for sound, audio, battery check. It's got a 1-inch internal sodium iodide probe, so for detection purposes. The next level up, which is one that we're going to be focusing on a little bit more, is the Model 3019. It's a modernized version of the Model 19, which gives you a digital readout, four button controls, and the biggest thing on it is it's auto ranging. It also has the addition of a 1-inch cesium iodide crystal, which is a lot more rugged. We'll get into some more of the features on this one here in just a minute, because we're going to be taking some measurements and doing some demonstrations with it. The next one we've got here is the Model 192. It is different in the fact it's only got four ranges that are multipliers. It also has an analog meter, on-off toggle switch for your response speed and your sound. It's got an alarm light, it's got a reset button. And the biggest thing addition on it over the Model 19 analog meter is the Sigma alarm. So instead of having the constant click audio that people are used to, it will only give you an audio alert whenever you run into a radiation source. It adjusts with the background radiation. Next, we've got the Model 193-6, which is our essentially the extended reach version of the Model 192. Again, it's analog meter, similar toggle switches, same range selector. It's also got the Sigma alarm, so it's going to alert you just with the adjusted floating background readings as to a radiation source. And the other big difference is it's got a 6-inch plastic scintillator on the end, which gives you much, much more surface area. And in radiation detection, size matters. It's why all of our radiation portal monitors have got, 3,500 cubic inches of plastic per detector. And then the next one we're going to be looking at is going to be the updated version of that, which is digital, again, with the 6-inch plastic scintillator on the end. It's got a digital readout, which again is auto-ranging. It's going to select the ranges for you so you don't have to turn the knobs. It's going to be lighter weight, and it's going to allow you to cover more ground and get a better reach. What we're going to do now is we're going to set up, we're going to do some demonstrations for you and show you the effective distance in shielding and the inverse square law and why handhelds are vital to the operations at a steel mill or a steel recycler. Okay, we're going to be doing some radiation detection tests to show you the importance and the effect of shielding and distance on these radiation detectors. Quick note, what we're using right here is cesium-137. It's a check source that goes out with a lot of our equipment, especially our radiation portal monitors. This thing's it's a 10 microcurie source. They're relatively harmless, they're sealed. It's not something that you want to carry around in your back pocket as a good luck charm, but they're relatively harmless and they're not going to hurt you as long as you take proper care of it. What we're going to do now, we'll put this back up in our pig so we can turn our instrument on. We're going to be using the Model 3019, which we've already gone over some. It's the updated model, version of the Model 19. You'll notice that it comes in a plastic casing. Some people don't like it, but we've actually done drop tests between it and the old workhorse, the Model 19, and the plastic has performed better, or this detector has performed better. The cesium iodide crystal has held up better and is more rugged than the sodium iodide. And as well, the plastic casing on the outside has a tendency to bounce once it hits concrete rather than cause damage to the detector is the model 19s are heavy enough and they're made of aluminum, they've shown dents rather than bouncing up off the concrete. So they are extremely rugged and they hold up really well. So what we're going to be doing first is we're going to turn our detector on. We're going to set it right here. It's going to go through an 8-second count to take the background radiation of the room that we're in. Then we're going to pull the source out. We're going to put it directly on the face of the detector so we can get a reading, and you'll see exactly what that contact reading is. Once we do that, we're going to stretch it out to a distance of 3 feet so that you can see the effect that distance has on these readings. Right now we're showing our background at between 6 and 7 microR per hour. Now we're going to pull our source out, which again is a 10 microcurie source, and place it directly on the meter face, and we are already up to 4.3 MR per hour. So we've gone up by, you know, a factor of 1,000 or 10 to the power of 3 over what we were, and that's a contact reading. So now that we're kind of back down to normal, we're going to come back out here. We're going to put our source at 3 feet in front of this meter. You can see the effect that the distance has. The alarm point, right now we're reading 12 microR per hour at a distance of 3 feet. So it's just, as I move in a little bit, it just begins to start to be enough to set off the alarm. Okay, what we're gonna do now is we are going to add into the mix a 1/2-inch thick steel plate so that you can see the effect of shielding on the readings. We're again gonna go at a contact reading. So directly in front of the meter with a 1/2-inch plate in between, we're up to 1.5 MR, which is about 1500 microR. So we're still getting a good strong reading, but considerable less than the 4.6 that we got the first time. Now if we move this out to a distance of 3 feet, it's gonna drop considerably more than that. From where I'm standing, I can't get a good reading out of this. But it drops down to about 14 or 15 microR. So it's considerable lower, but we're right on the verge of that alarm point. If you're really checking an area, you're probably going to get some beeps and you're going to get a reading, which means you're going to need to look into it further. Okay, so thanks for being with us through these demonstrations, and I hope that the demonstrations we did helped you understand the importance and the effect of distance and shielding from a radiation source to the detector and why it's important in the steel industry. You're going to have trucks come through that have a lot of steel in them. There's going to be a lot of shielding, say if there's a radiation source somewhere in there. So these handheld microR meters can help you locate and deal with the offending source. If you have any further questions, feel free to contact me or anybody at sales at Ludlum Measurements. Again, my name was Nick Morgan. If you need more technical information, we've got it listed on the website. And again, if you need anything at all, feel free to give us a call up here at the plant. Thanks.